Well, this hand's awkward as hell. We're just never casting this card, but we do have a 2-drop, and we are pretty reasonably gonna be able to cast this guy. So we're not gonna mulligan, I guess. But we very well might just lose. Forest? Come on, forest. It's not a forest. Though that's something I'll probably be able to cast, so that's good. It's a lot worse than our 2-drop into our deal hand, which admittedly did not get there, but that's a good draw. This card is great. Do kind of like how they made more of these like Wingsteed Rider type cards, but like waited till there was way less enchantments so they weren't as stupid. But granted, this guy doesn't even have evasion or anything, but still pretty good. Feel like they might know what they're doing over there. At WotC. The other thing I like is that, I just spent a lot of time thinking about block and stuff, is that they put all like the good enablers for devotion in the previous block so that it wasn't totally horrible in the block format. It wasn't just like mono black devotion and mono blue devotion just based on Grey Merchant and Thassa or in Masterwaves. I don't think anyone really was playing devotion decks. So, kudos. Okay. Let's just play as Rotted Hulk. It's the same card right now. Or same power right now. Does feel good when your opponent's turn 4 plays a Voyaging End on your guy that you could recast if you wanted to. Man, when I draw a forest, I am going to go nuts with centaurs. I actually need to draw 2 forests to do that, but even just like putting both those guys in play, I don't even know if it's particularly good, but it's gonna make me happy. It's sweet. Apparently this is how you win with god-awful decks, is just your opponent gets mana screwed, and you get lucky. Yep. You're out of it. Probably got Sudden Storm over there. Sudden Storm. Like that is, I feel like he has to have Divine Verdict. We didn't see it, but like, I mean, he could have 3-2 flyer. I am generally okay with just not attacking the Verdict, but I'm also not doing anything, so it doesn't really favor either of us a lot. If I just get to add to the board, it's great. All right, well, this I don't care about. You're trading for a 2-2. Ah, my Fleshmaid's Deed got tapped. Now, I mean, it is true that still traded, but like that's pretty much unavoidable. You can just play it in a turn and then still do it anyway. So. Though, I'm probably not even favored to win this game at this point because I can't cast any cards in my hands. He just got out of his mana screw, which means he has like a bunch of cards in hand that he can now cast, whereas I can't cast mine. It's like, guess we'll see. Maybe just has Sudden Storm right here, buys him more time. Now, which thing is even right to play here? Probably the golden thing. Definitely not the Centaur Lord. Ferris Band, whatever, is just bigger. Yeah, it's probably just the biggest guy possible. All right, you have to block him. Maybe I can just eat whatever he plays next. We'll see. See if I draw an enchantment. I don't even know what it would be. Probably a grizzly transformation, in which case I just we get to attack through. Oh, that's not gonna do anything. It's actually a pretty sick late top deck just in general, despite it being a one drop, but I think I'll just be casting Ferris Band 3/7s. Man, this guy's probably like, what in the hell is happening? Why am I losing this nonsense? Like, look what's in play. This is the only card of these that I would actually even want in my deck. This is stupid. All right, we did it. See you guys for round two.